What's up, guys? Houndish here, and today we're jumping in with a loot breakdown and overview for Beyond Light and Season of the Hunt. So, we are going to speak about where we can acquire the bulk of the rewards for this expansion. That will include exotics, with all of the sources and things to know about how to get to those sources, as well as the core, armor, and weapon rewards. We're going to talk about weapon rolls, where everything can be acquired, and we'll speak a little bit about badge and exclusive rewards for the season, as well as Adept Trials rewards, all of the new Adept mods. And I will put timestamps for the main sections of this video down in the description below. So, guys, as always, I hope you do find this one useful. And if you do enjoy the content, feel free to get subscribed so I can keep you up to date. But now let's get into it. Initially, let's speak about exotics and pursuit items. Once again, there are timestamps for the core sections of the video down in the description, but for exotic armor, as we've learned, this is going to drop from Legend or Master Lost Sectors, and that includes all six of the new exotic armors, two per class. And of course, the Lost Sectors need to be soloed in Legend or Master mode on the Cosmodrome and Europa for rare chances at these to drop. Currently, they're quite difficult because they're pretty high level, but of course, it's something that'll get easier in the coming weeks as we power up. Only things to note about getting access to these is that they do appear after the main campaign for Beyond Light, and as far as we know, you also have to have discovered a Lost Sector before its Legend or Master version will show up. Otherwise, our exotic weapons are from pursuits this season as well, so Salvation's Grip drops in the exotic quest at the end of the Beyond Light campaign. The Lament exotic sword is going to be a quest weapon, and so naturally, it'll appear for us in-game, most likely a little bit later on in the season, requiring a number of different quest steps to be completed, as well as some mission content. And then Hawkmoon, the Season of the Hunt exotic quest weapon, is something else that will be led to during the Hunt content rollout. But something a bit more targetable would be the Cloudstrike exotic sniper, and this will be a rare drop when completing Elected Difficulty Empire Hunts. So, Elect Difficulty is something that will unlock for Empire Hunts by upgrading Varric's Sabotage menu, and specifically, the fourth perk in the blue row of unlocks is what will enable access to selection, something we're going to be able to get done fairly soon. And finally, the biggest spoiler of the video, really, and so skip ahead now if you don't want any info about raid stuff, but there is the Eyes of Tomorrow exotic rocket launcher. We know it to be associated with the Deepstone Crypt. It doesn't appear to be a conventional quest weapon, as it were, but of course it comes from a raid, so it's entirely possible that puzzles or other precursor requirements will be needed in order to get access to this. And so that rounds up the exotic weapons and armor, at least in terms of the sources. But there are also rewards associated with the badges this season, so that would include items like raid exotics, the Ghost and Sparrow, but also exotic ships and emblems from other badges. And luckily, these are very visible and trackable in the game. But moving our attention to Adored, of course, this is the new ritual weapon for the season. And in terms of acquiring it, probably the Vanguard quest is the fastest way if you have a team. So my friend Jarv has a video about this, but you can farm the Corrupted Strike. So pick that from the destination map, but with a team of three, and then head to the Blind Well to actually go ahead and farm out the bulk of that quest. And specifically, the boss kills that are required can kind of be cheesed in the Blind Well, because the bosses in final rounds there actually count like strike bosses as far as the quest is concerned. So of course you need sniper rifle kills, precision final blows are going to grant the most progress there, and you need to kill any combatants while a sniper rifle is equipped, which is around 1,000 kills, so it's still going to take a bit of farming, but cycling through Blind Well runs with snipers equipped, of course, is a pretty quick way to do this. And once again, I'll link Jarv's video down below, because the Vanguard variant of the quest is going to be the fastest way, but if you're not a big PvP'er and are solo, Gambit is probably the next best option. My friend Kuki's been running this, and of course you need to farm precision kills and points more or less the same way as you would in the Vanguard, but also complete a bunch of Gambit bounties and matches to get the Infamy rank ups, which happen pretty fast. But otherwise, if you enjoy the Crucible, there is that option as well. And also, once the weapon's unlocked, you will find additional short quests at the respective vendors to unlock the playlist ornaments for the weapon, which you can see on the screen right now. Of course, there are Europa weapons, and there are a bunch that Varric's actually has and can be reacquired, so some folks were asking how can you farm the weapons. We do get a bunch during the campaign, but once you finish the main campaign and some of the kind of side questing immediately after that on Europa, you'll see that Varric's has weekly quests for Empire Hunts, each of them able to reward different weapons. And obviously these are going to cycle out on different weeks, so it'll be something to look out for, and there are various upgrades on Varric's perk list that will decrease the costs to run Empire Hunts and farm weapons and stuff like that. And then his armor, of course, also comes from those kind of mini quests where you need to unseal chests around Europa. Easiest way to acquire those initially is just to keep picking them up, and the chests do tend to be in locations where you're running through campaign stuff as well. And so Varric's weapons would include Biting Winds, a new precision frame kinetic bow. And in terms of trait slots, at least, you get Killing Wind, No Distractions, Moving Target, Rapid Hit, Quick Draw, or Surplus in slot 1, and Surplus increases handling, reload, and stability for each fully charged ability. And slot 2 perks can get Unrelenting, Sympathetic Arsenal, Swashbuckler, Rangefinder, Explosive Head, or Snapshot Sights. Some potentially interesting roles there for that. But then we have the Hailing Confusion, a new kinetic pulse rifle, and it's actually an adaptive frame right there, with main traits consisting of Outlaw, Slideways, Firmly Planted, Pulse Monitor, Surplus once again, or Zen Moment. And then you do have Elemental Capacitor, Unrelenting, Full Auto Trigger System, Demolitionist, Quick Draw, or Wellspring, where kills with the weapon generate ability energy, and this energy is divided between your uncharged abilities. That's a pretty interesting one. But there is the High Albedo Sidearm as well, a kinetic adaptive frame sidearm, and this one can get Ambitious Assassin, Slideways, Threat Detector, Surplus, Killing Wind, or Full Auto Trigger System in slot 1, with Snapshot Sights, Wellspring, Unrelenting, Demolitionist, Headseeker, and High Impact Reserves in slot 2. The Arctic Haze is the new energy auto rifle, and of course it is a rapid fire frame. This one can get Genesis, Killing Wind, Triple Tap, we've also got Mulligan, Outlaw, or Subsistence in slot 1, and then Unrelenting, Elemental Capacitor, Vorpal Weapon, Dragonfly, Thresh, where killing combatants with this weapon generates a small amount of super energy, kind of a bad juju style perk I suppose there, could be pretty good on a pulse rifle, but it can also get Eye of the Storm in slot 2 as well. And then we have the Coriolis Force, an aggressive frame fusion rifle right there, and perks in slot 1 include Ambitious Assassin, Pulse Monitor, Under Pressure, Killing Wind, Moving Target, or Feeding Frenzy, with slot 2 seeing Slideways, Eye of the Storm, Unrelenting, Rangefinder, or One for All, where hitting 3 separate targets increases damage for a moderate duration. That sounds interesting as well, but also it can get Thresh. Bone Chiller is a new precision frame energy shotgun, and you can get Firmly Planted or Dual Loader, where it reloads 2 shells at a time but reduces reload speed, and that is by -50, so pretty interesting trade-off. You also get Lead from Gold, Surplus, Autoloading Holster, or Triple Tap. And then slot 2 can see Dragonfly, Demolitionist, Slideways, One for All, Threat Detector, or Opening Shot. But the final two weapons that Varix will feature include Thermal Erosion, a new rapid-fire frame machine gun, so we will at least get access to one new machine gun there, with potential of Killing Wind, Quick Draw, Zen Moment, Underdog, Hipfire Grip, or Field Prep in slot 1. And then Dragonfly, Dynamic Sway Reduction, Wellspring, Snapshot, Demolitionist, or Tap the Trigger in slot 2. And then there is also the Sub-Zero Salvo, a precision frame rocket launcher. And this one is interesting, it can get Killing Wind, Moving Target, Ambitious Assassin, Underdog, Surplus, or Quick Draw in slot 1, but a new bonus called Chain Reaction, where each final blow with the weapon creates an elemental damage explosion. That's actually a really good bonus there. And then you can get Unrelenting, Cluster Bomb, Thresh, Demolitionist, or Snapshot Sights. So once again, those are all of the weapons that you can find via the Varix quests, Empire Hunts, and Farm For to try and get some pretty nice rolls. Otherwise, in terms of new stuff, there are the Adept Trials weapons, and these are going to come with an additional mod slot, as well as the exclusive shader. But taking a look at the Adept weapon mods, of course, they'll roll on the archetypes that they actually apply to, but you get things like Adept Accuracy, and all of these grant plus 10 to that stat. So we get plus 10 accuracy, you also have Adept Blast Radius, Adept Charge Time, Adept Counterbalance, and this greatly improves recoil direction at the cost of range. But obviously it's gonna be a higher stat version of that bonus. And then there is also Adept Draw Time, Handling, and Impact, as well as Adept Mag, which greatly increases the magazine at the cost of handling. And finally, Adept Projectile Speed, Range, Reload, Stability, and Targeting, which will increase that target acquisition at the cost of stability. And so these are the specific Adept mods that will roll out and drop from the Lighthouse on the top tier versions of Trials weapons. Now before we talk seasonal and additional rewards, but otherwise, the actual perk rolls and the potential perk rolls for those stay the same. And those are the same perks specifically that we've seen in previous seasons for the trial stuff. Speaking about stasis just for a moment, of course there are various unlocks and pursuits involved in getting access to the bonuses. So in terms of upcoming aspects for these subclasses, Shapebinder currently has Frost Pulse as an aspect, and casting your rift generates a shockwave that freezes nearby combatants. However, Ice Flare Bolts will be the next upgrade, and shattering a frozen target will spawn Seekers that track and freeze other nearby targets. So That sounds pretty awesome. The Titan currently has Cryoclasm as an available aspect, and it enables a longer and more powerful slide, and sliding into crystals or frozen targets will shatter them and any nearby frozen targets. But the next unlock will be Tectonic Harvest, and shattering a stasis crystal creates a stasis shard, and this shard grants melee energy when picked up by you or your allies. Once again, quite an interesting idea. And then we've got the Revenant. So hunters currently get Shatter Drive, and you can activate while midair to quickly descend and shatter nearby targets on impact. But the upcoming bonus will be Winter's Shroud, where dodging slows nearby targets. The additional aspect is something that we're going to unlock over time, obviously via quest content. But, of course, the Born Out of Darkness quests, which also become accessible after the campaign and are going to roll out on a weekly basis, are the ones which reward stasis fragments. And when we complete a quest, we get access to one of six of the fragments, able to earn a total of 2 per week. So there is Whisper of Hedrons, where you gain a bonus to weapon damage after freezing a target with stasis. Whisper of Fissures, and this increases the damage and size of the burst of stasis when you destroy a stasis crystal or defeat a frozen target. Refraction, where defeating slowed or frozen targets grants you class ability energy. And then we have Endurance, where slow from your abilities lasts longer, and for those abilities that linger, their duration will also increase. But there's Whisper of Bonds, where defeating frozen targets with weapons grants you super energy. And finally, Whisper of Shards, where shattering a stasis crystal temporarily boosts your grenade recharge rate, and shattering additional stasis crystals increases the duration of this benefit. That's the full list of how we can acquire stasis fragments and aspects, as well as the ones that are going to come up over the next few weeks. And of course, once again, it appears that we get the option to pick any of them when we complete those 2 quests per week. Now, as well, we do have the Season of the Hunt content, and of course, initially there is the Season Pass, so all of those rewards are kind of self-explanatory, as well as other badge rewards that you can see for Europa and stuff like that. We're really focusing in on the weapons and armor, but there will be 3 weapons available via the hunts that we'll get as part of Season 12. Possibly the most interesting one would be Deafening Whisper, a new energy grenade launcher, which is a waveframe, one-shot handheld grenade launcher, and projectiles release a wave of energy when they contact the ground. This can get Killing Wind, Underdog, Lead from Gold, Moving Target, Ambitious Assassin, and Surplus, but also Rampage, Threat Detector, Wellspring, Unrelenting, Snapshot Sights, and Auto-Loading Holster. You've got Implosion and High Velocity rounds as well. So it will be an interesting weapon to try out, but there is the Friction Fire, a precision frame kinetic SMG, so that's 600 rounds per minute. We haven't had a whole ton of those recently, and it can get Killing Wind, Subsistence, Threat Detector, Auto-Loading Holster, Zen Moment, and Field Prep, as well as Unrelenting, Sympathetic Arsenal, Slideways, Wellspring, Vorpal Weapon, and Rampage in slot 2. With finally the Corsair's Wrath, the new linear fusion rifle, being an additional weapon for those hunts. And we've got Firmly Planted, Killing Wind, Pulse Monitor, Moving Target, No Distractions, and Outlaw, as well as Quick Draw, Unrelenting, Demolitionist, Thresh, Kill Clip, and High Impact Reserves. Those are the currently listed season activity specific weapons for Season of the Hunt in the database. And finally, in terms of new additions in legendary weapons, there are some playlist ones. So we have the Crowd Pleaser, a new grenade launcher which is adaptive frame. This will drop when you complete Gambit matches and earn rank up packages from the Drifter. And it gets Grave Robber, Underdog, Ambitious Assassin, Genesis, Killing Wind, Field Prep, Surplus, Clown Cartridge, Pulse Monitor, or Threat Detector in slot 1, with slot 2 seeing the potential of Moving Target, Rampage, Unrelenting, Elemental Capacitor, Snapshot, Thresh, Demolitionist, Chain Reaction once again, and Quick Draw. Chain Reaction could be a very, very good perk on a grenade launcher in particular. And then there is the Stars in Shadow, and this one comes from Crucible rank up packages. It's High Impact Frame, it goes in the energy slot with solar damage, and we can see the Threat Detector, Genesis, Field Prep, Underdog, Firmly Planted, Quick Draw, Surplus, Killing Wind, Feeding Frenzy, Outlaw, Pulse Monitor, or Grave Robber are available in slot 1, with Disruption Break, Eye of the Storm, Kill Clip, Snapshot, Headseeker, Moving Target, Thresh, Demolitionist, Dragonfly, Sympathetic Arsenal, Vorpal Weapon, and Elemental Capacitor available to drop in slot 2. Another weapon which could be pretty decent if you get some nice rolls would be a lightweight frame energy shotgun called Xenoclast. Does arc damage, and it does drop inside of strikes or from Vanguard rank up packages, and you get Lead from Gold, Slideways, Grave Robber, Pulse Monitor, Underdog, Dual Loader, Surplus, Slideshot, Hipfire Grip, Genesis, Field Prep, or Auto-Loading Holster in slot 1. With Unrelenting, Demolitionist, 1-2 Punch, Rampage, Trench Barrel, Thresh, Killing Wind, Vorpal Weapon, Surrounded, Swashbuckler, Eye of the Storm, or Disruption Break in slot 2. So according to some of these rolls right there, actually, some of the playlist weapons, at least in terms of perks, have a lot of potential. But for now, in terms of core rewards, weapons, armor, exotics, and of course recognizing the fact that many exotics will come from quests, you've also got season pass items, and then raid loot, which we haven't discussed in this video. That should be a pretty good idea of all of the items that are available in this expansion. And so, once again, give us your thoughts on the loot, guys. All of the new stuff that we've got. I know loot at the moment is a big conversation in the community, so as always, I'm curious to get your thoughts in the comments section. But if you've enjoyed the video, a rating is very much appreciated down below. And also feel free to get subscribed to the channel so that I can keep you posted on all the new content. But otherwise, I hope you guys have an awesome day.